Hi guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel. Today we are going to see about a simple DC motor. Let's start.
Let's have a look at parts of a simple DC motor.
Coil, split ring commutator, carbon brush, then magnets, north pole and south pole.
Let's have a look at the action of a simple DC motor.
Here is a simple DC motor. I have fixed all the parts. Here is the coil made of insulated copper wire. It is free to rotate between the poles of a magnet. A commutator or split ring, which will be below this carbon brush, is fixed to this coil and rotates along with it. So there will be a gap. So it is known as split ring commutator or split ring. The purpose of the split ring commutator is to change the current direction in the coil. For one complete rotation, the split ring commutator will change the current direction twice in this coil. We will see in detail in the next video. The brushes are two contacts which rub against the split ring commutator and keep the coil connected to the battery. They are usually made of carbon, so it is sometimes called as carbon brushes. So this is the internal view of a simple DC motor I have connected to a battery. Let's switch on and check. So now it is rotating in this way, that is clockwise direction. Let me change the current direction and check the direction the coil moves. Now I have changed the current direction. First, the coil was moving in this direction, that is clockwise direction. I have changed the current direction. Let's see in which direction the coil moves. So now it is moving in this way, that is anti-clockwise direction. By using Fleming's left hand rule, we can detect the direction of the movement of coil. The turning effect on the coil can be increased by increasing the current, using a stronger magnet, increasing the number of turns on the coil, and increasing the area of the coil. A longer coil means higher forces because there is a greater length of wire in this magnetic field. I hope you got it.
Let's try some questions from simple DC motor. Try this first question. Which device uses a split ring commutator? Option A, a transformer. Option B, a relay. Option C, a DC motor. Option D, an AC generator. Your time starts now. The correct answer is C, a DC motor. No need of looking at other devices. As you all are very familiar, a DC motor uses split ring commutator. Try this second question. A current carrying coil is placed in a magnetic field. Which effect does the coil experience? Option A, a change in shape. Option B, a turning effect. Option C, a resultant force. Option D, a change in weight. Your time starts now. The correct answer is B. When a current carrying coil is placed in a magnetic field, it experiences a force which causes a turning effect on a coil. So B, a turning effect, is the right answer. Try this last question. A current carrying coil in a magnetic field experiences a turning effect. How can the turning effect be increased? Option A, use thinner wire for the coil. Option B, reduce the size of the current. Option C, reverse the direction of the magnetic field. Option D, increase the number of turns on the coil. Your time starts now. The correct answer is D. Increase the number of turns on the coil will increase the turning effect on a coil.
I hope you got something about a simple DC motor. See you soon with another video with a detailed turning effect on a coil and action of split ring commutator in a DC motor. Thank you.